See the vegetable man in the vegetable van with the horn that's honking like a mariachi band. In the middle of the street, people gather around. Put the dollar in the can. I wait, K-O-T-A. TJ Cowboys hang.
Hi, everybody. I'm James Yodice. I'm the high school sports editor at the Albuquerque Journal. Ken Sickenger, former prep sports editor at the Journal, one of our longtime writers. We are back to talk high school football this year as the 2019 season begins on Thursday. As we tape this, it is Tuesday afternoon, 48 hours before kickoff. These off seasons seem to go by so fast.
They do, and here we are out in the heat, and it does not feel like football season, but we're going to go get it.
Right, we should say this. Our boss, Randy Harrison, does the videoing here. It's about 97 degrees out here, so we're going to do this quick. We're going to talk about week one of the season. We've got some interesting matchups in the metro area. The biggest one on Thursday night, Volcano Vista, which is my preseason number one in the metro area, against my number two team, La Cueva. They play on Thursday night at Community Stadium at 7. I would rather these teams played like in week four or five and we had some momentum built up, but what a great opener.
Yeah, I agree, and I think it's going to be kind of strange. It'd be nice if it was week five just so you could build up a little bit of hype, but it, you know, for as a regular season opener goes, this is as good as it gets.
Yeah. I should tell you right off the top of the bat, you can see Ken's picks and my picks weekly in the Albuquerque Journal on Thursday mornings. You can see them at abqjournal.com. as well, as early as Wednesday night. Ken and I are going to be talking high school football every week for a few minutes, talking some of the key games. This week I've been counting down my top five teams in the metro area. Rio Rancho was my number five team, Las Lunas was my number four team, Cleveland at 3, La Cueva at 2, Volcano Vista is my number one team, maybe a bit of a stretch, but this team looks as well-rounded, if not more well-rounded than they were last year. They're going to have a chance to make me look very silly or very smart on opening night when they play La Cueva.
You know, I'm going the opposite on that because I still recall smarting last year when La Cueva made us both look very stupid in the 6A title game. So if one of us didn't pick them, I don't want to start there.
Yeah, and we'll give you a quick breakdown. I mean, Volcano Vista is a very senior-laden team this year. They've got Diego Pavia, quarterback who excelled at St. Pius, had to sit out last year for transfer rules. He's back. I look forward to seeing what he can do, even against better athletes at the 6A level than what he faced against when he was at St. Pius. La Cueva is having to replace four first-team All-State players off that defense that was so great last year. That's something we need to watch for. Cleveland with Dorian Lewis coming off his ACL surgery to his right knee last December. The injury occurred last October. He had surgery last December. All of the top teams have sort of something they need to address.
Yeah, I agree. And we won't find out probably as much with Cleveland until a couple weeks into the season. But yeah, if Dorian Lewis is back to what he was, who knows how big a difference maker he
exactly. Is. Yeah, and that's one of the real X factors of the season. Cleveland opens at home Friday night against Oñate. La Cueva Volcano is the big game on Thursday night. Friday night, a couple of decent games. Las Cruces is playing Manzano High School at Wilson Stadium. Centennial, the game I'm going to be at, is visiting Rio Rancho. You're going to be at Sandia Cibola. Chad Adcox, now Sandia's head coach. New era. It'll be totally different from Kevin Barker.
Yeah, it will be. And that's an interesting opening game. I couldn't decide on who to pick with that one because Cibola tends to play pretty tough. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to some of those games.
Yeah, some interesting Friday night games on the slate. Saturday, a couple of interesting games involving some of the smaller schools, including two number one seeds from the last playoffs. Hope, which was the number one seed in 3A, is playing Portales on Saturday afternoon. St. Pius, which was the number one seed in 4A, is at home against Goddard, which was a 5A semifinalist last year. So both the Huskies and the Sartans have really tough openers this year.
Yeah, they do. And it's a couple of the good Southern teams in town right away. So that'll be interesting to see how they do.
Yeah. And as we go along, when some of the other Southern teams get into town, we're going to talk a little bit more about them. Teams like Clovis, Centennial, Mayfield. Mayfield's a team that's interesting to me. They're pretty senior heavy like Volcano Vista. But as I said, you can see Ken's picks and my picks every week in the Journal. We're going to try and have some fun with this season. We thank our boss, Randy Harrison, for taking care of the video. We did this in two takes. You won't know this behind the camera, but it took us two takes to do this today. Last year, we did everything in one take, so it was already an ominous start for me and for Ken. Well, not for Ken, but just for me. So enjoy week one of the high school season, and we will see you next week.